Yeah, I think ESG investing in Africa is at a really exciting point in its journey. I think there are lots of opportunities. If you look at Africa, Africa hasn't always followed the same route as other parts of the world. If you look at mobile telecommunications, for example, it skipped landlines. If you look at digital payments, it's moved straight to that to foster financial inclusion. In the energy space, I think there's a real opportunity with the significant energy and infrastructure gap that Africa has to adopt a sort of decentralized renewable energy system. So I think for Africa, there's lots of opportunity. There's obviously commitments at COP around investment going into developing markets, and that can only benefit Africa. I think, like many perceived risks for Africa, the reality on the ground is sometimes quite different. I think COVID hasn't had the sort of impact that maybe many expected. Maybe that's because of a younger population in Africa. I think as an investor, it has made deals more challenging to sort of complete, but I think that's been the same sort of globally. At Helios, we've managed to sort of complete and close on sort of two deals during the pandemic, which is great. And I think for Helios, we're quite fortunate in that we have two offices, one in Lagos, one in Nairobi, which has meant that we've been able to continue to have that face time with our portfolio companies and continue to work with them. Yeah, I think we've seen commitments from countries and governments around incorporating ESG into sort of the recovery plans post pandemic. I think there's going to need to be huge investments into Africa. If those are ESG aligned, it's going to make them more resilient in the longer term and more valuable as well when investors come to exit those investments. I also think there's a real opportunity around how we engage the sort of youth and women in society to reduce unemployment in those countries and also to focus on localization to avoid imports in Africa, which obviously costs a lot of money to the African economy and also isn't addressing the employment challenges in Africa as well. Yeah, I think the landscape's going to change in that I think there's going to be increased focus on issue-specific funds. An example of this is at Glasgow in the last few days, Helios has just announced a CLEAR fund, which is a climate-focused fund. I also think we're going to see funds that focus on specific challenges, for example, currency risk. I think there's going to be more investment in sort of new technologies and also to make Africa more resilient and more sort of localization, so less reliance on imports for Africa. So working with companies, looking at new investments that help support that.